So let's imagine I am a developer. I'm sitting down and I need to solve a problem. What would be a common problem I might want to solve? Well, let's see. I commonly work with a library called Twilio where we send SMS or voice messages. Well, let me type in just SMS. So I want to find a package that will help me do SMS. And there's actually quite a bit in here. I'm a fan of the one called Twilio. Let's say I go look at this first one, SMS, a simple library for sending transactional messages. Okay, well, it has a couple thousand downloads. Twilio has over 1 million downloads. It's been recently updated. The NuGet page for the Twilio package actually gives me a lot of really useful information. The first part is how do you get Twilio into your application? I'm going to show you the GUI way here in a moment. But you could also use command line using PowerShell to install the Twilio package. If we were using .NET Core, we could use the .NET CLI to add a package. And there's also a packet, a third-party NuGet client. If I scroll down, there's no documentation for this particular package. I probably should have picked a better one. But some packages have full documentation here to tell you what the package is about, maybe a little bit of usage. Or just things that you should know about. Dependencies. Now, we're probably not going to go too in depth into dependencies for different packages, but what's really nice about this Twilio package is that it supports multiple versions of the .NET framework. But there are some things where if I develop a library built in, say, .NET 4 or 5, I can't really use that in a .NET 3.5 application because it's built on a newer version of the framework than what my application is used on. So it's common practice for some of the more popular applications out there or more popular packages. They support multiple versions of the .NET framework. And so I can look at these dependencies and I can say, all right, well, my application is running .NET 4.5. I should be safe installing the Twilio library. Everything should at least compile. I shouldn't have any major problems. And maybe down the line, if I start another application and it's built off .NET standard for 1.4 or higher, I could still pull in this library and everything should hopefully work. If I scroll down, there's a little bit of version history. I like Twilio because it's been a very active project over the past couple of years. We can go back through every version of the Twilio package and see how many people downloaded it, when was it released. This is useful for us because maybe I will build my application based around Twilio 5.6.0. If I'm built on 5.6.0, 5.7 comes out, 5.8, well, maybe these have breaking changes. Not like major breaking changes, but just subtle. It worked in 5.6, but doesn't work in 5.7. I am under no major timeline to upgrade my packages. I can say I'm 5.6 as long as I want to. It will always be up in NuGet. It's never going to go away. And this helps. What if we're just overwriting this file over and over and over again? Well, there's no version management. If that file gets overwritten, and then all of a sudden Kevin over here sends the email out and then goes, I might have fixed one bug, but I introduced two more because who's never done that? I don't have any way to go back and pull the old version back again. With NuGet, I have all the versions here. So maybe we do upgrade. We go from 5.6 up to 5.7. Well, there's nothing stopping us from downgrading a day later. So every version's up here. We'll also talk a little bit about pre-release versions. So if there's betas available to us, Twilio in this case does not have any pre-releases available to it. If I wanted to find an example, I think Application Insights is a good example. So here's a great example. Our current version that everyone should be using is 2.4.0, but there are a couple issues in that version that have been fixed in 2.5. But 2.5 is not ready for everyone to go upgrade. So they mark it as a beta or it's marked as a pre-release. So it's not going to become the current version because it has that dash beta attached to it. It will always be a pre-release package. So the only people that can install or download that are the ones who selectively agree, yes, I am going to download a pre-release.